So this is a very quick video. Just I was reading something sort of interesting about mullein, which is one of the plants that I was talking about last week. Specifically, the seeds of the mullein, like the cob or the seed stem, whatever it happens to be called, has tons of seeds. And I'm like, well, I know this is used as medicine, but I don't hear any reference to the seeds being used in medicine generally. It's always other parts of the plant. So what I discovered is that it actually the seeds contain a potentially toxic and actually dangerous because it can cause a Parkinson's disease. Overuse is one of the theories. And this rotenone is probably how it's pronounced. It's actually usable as an insecticide, pesticide, that's not pea, that's fish, and pesticide. So I'm thinking, like, if you soak these seeds, you could probably use it as like a spray to ward off against the animals that are insects that, this is just a theory at this point, I haven't tried it. Things like cabbage beetles or caterpillars is how it was traditionally used. So it's also used for catching fish, but it's illegal to use for that purpose. Like as a fishing, you just put it in the water and the fish will float to the surface. I think there's some other pesticides that do the same thing, but this is traditionally how it's been used by indigenous groups. So I don't know, like obviously it's not doable that way, but it kills potato beetles, cucumber beetles, flea beetles, cabbage worms, raspberry beetles, and asparagus beetles, and most other arthropods or arthropods. So like probably ladybugs, maybe ladybugs. I'm not sure if it does ladybugs, but it also biodegrades rapidly in soil with 90% degraded after 1 to 3 months. At 20 degrees Celsius and 3 times faster at 30 degrees Celsius. So this is normally something that's in certain types of seeds, and there's a variety of plants that I've never heard of before. Hori pea, jicama, kube, barbasco, tube plant, jewel vine, common mullein, cork bush, and Florida fish poison tree. Wonder where they got that name from. And Miletietia or Tephrosia. So it's global. It's used globally. It's been used globally. But it's in the process of sort of being banned as a pesticide or insecticide. But I'm still thinking for an SHTF type situation. Just in harvesting those seeds, soaking them or grinding them and using it as like a dissolved powder. I'm thinking that usually the insecticides are on the surface of the seeds. So if you soak those seeds, I'm thinking that if it's water soluble, I'm not sure yet if it's water soluble, I'm guessing it is, that you can then spray that in the area you don't want these bugs, like on plants or saplings. I know my bugs got eaten up by green little caterpillars and like everything they're talking about. And then, I've been delivered this mullein seed this year, just sort of at random. I didn't seek it out. It's what found me. So I'm thinking maybe it's the answer to that problem is that I can soak these and use it as like a insecticidal spray, natural, and see what happens with that. So if I'm growing next year, and I have, like, I've obviously packed away some of the seed, I intend to grow or plant some of it in certain growing areas. So hopefully, this will be a usable strategy. Now, this plant takes 2 years to mature. So the first year, it's just the leaf, which I'm guessing is has certain properties. Second year, it grows into the full seed head. So keep an eye out for it. If you don't use or don't want to buy pesticides and insecticides, research this and learn more. What I'm curious about now is, after soaking this, is it going to be edible? Because the issue was that it was toxic due to the presence of this chemical on the surface of the seed. Again, I don't know if it's present within the entire seed or just as a surface coating. So it's something to look into. I suggest you look into it yourself, since it's a very common plant globally, particularly in North America and Europe. So Mullein, Mullein. Let's see here. Mullein. Verbascum thapsus. So look it up, do your research, and it's just what I encountered today.